Good morning, class. So today we're going to continue our discussion of our dynamics. Specifically, we're going to continue the application of the concept of Newton's second law of motion and free body diagram towards the solution of problems in dynamics. So at this point, I will pause to see if anyone has any questions on Newton's second law or the concept of the free body diagram as we discussed last week, so that I can clarify before we can start. Good, no questions. So today we will be applying those concepts towards the calculation of the acceleration of a system. And the problem in focus today is sketched up as follows. So consider this as a table or some surface. And then we have some mass, M1, and we have another mass, M2. And M1 is connected to M2 by a cord and then over a pulley. And the task today is to calculate the acceleration of the system using the concepts I've mentioned already. We have to make a couple of simplifying assumptions to solve this problem. And those assumptions are, first of all, we're going to say there's no friction between mass M2 and the surface of the table. So here the coefficient of sliding and the coefficient of static friction above zero. We're going to say the cord is weightless, we assume that, and there's no friction in the pulley system. With this assumption, we proceed with the solution or with the calculation of the acceleration of the system as follows. Firstly, we draw out the free body diagram of mass 1. And as I said, we talked about this last week. Feel free to raise your hand and ask me any question if you need clarity. The free body diagram, I'm going to abbreviate as FBD of mass 1, is drawn as follows. The first thing you do is that you draw your Cartesian coordinate system. For this problem, a two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system will do. This is our positive y-axis, and this is our positive x-axis. Next, you assume that mass M1 is a point mass at the origin of this system. And finally, you draw all forces acting on mass 1, but no forces that mass 1 exert on other bodies in the system. And the forces acting on mass 1 are the tension, T, and the weight of mass 1, which is W1. Remember from previous chapter, we said that the weight of an object on Earth, close to the surface of the Earth, is given as the mass of that object times the gravitational acceleration of that object. I would like for us to review Newton's second law before we proceed. We said that in past, Newton's second law states that the vector sum of all forces acting on the body is equal to the mass of that body times the acceleration of that body. With this reminder, we can go ahead and write down the equation of motion of mass M1. Which goes to say the sum of all forces acting on mass m1 in the y direction is equal to the acceleration of mass m1 times the mass of m1. I'm saying y direction because there are no forces in the x direction, so we ignore that. We can put a minus sign here because mass 1 is going to accelerate downwards. Usually or generally, you don't have to worry about this sum because it's going to come up naturally from the mathematics, but we know this beforehand, so we can include it. Do we have any question? Oh, okay, I thought I saw your answer. That's fine. So, with this, we say the sum of forces acting on M1 in the y direction is the tension minus the weight. And this is just the tension minus the weight as defined here, M1g. So, we equate these two expressions, and we have the tension minus mass 1 times acceleration due to gravity is the negative of mass 1 times its acceleration. And this is the equation of motion for mass M1. We can now draw the free body diagram of mass M2. And at this point, I would like a volunteer to tell me how to draw the free body diagram of mass M2. Yeah, you over there. That's correct. So as she said, the free body diagram of mass M2 can be drawn as follows. Our Cartesian plane first, positive y, positive x-axis. Mass M2 has a weight, M2, she was right, which is equal to the mass of M2 times gravitational acceleration. Because mass M2 sits on the surface, there is a reaction force. Remember from previous chapter, Newton's third law, and we call that the normal force. And there's a tension in the string that pulls mass M2 to the right. We call that T. Yeah, thank you. Okay, so with this free body diagram, we can write out the equation of motion of mass M2. But do we have to consider the force up or the force down? Thank you, Olivia. We do not have to, because there's no motion in this direction. She's right. So we do not have to consider these forces. They don't contribute to the acceleration. So we can write down the equation of motion for M2, considering the force in the x direction. the acceleration, I mean the sum of forces in the x direction of mass m2 is just the mass of m2 times its acceleration, and the sum of forces in the x direction for m2 is just the tension. We equate these two equations, these two expressions, and we say T is m2a. And this is the equation of motion of mass m2. Remember, we're using a for acceleration of mass m1, a for acceleration of mass m2. That is because the acceleration of the system is unique. M1 and m2 has the same acceleration because the string neither stretches nor breaks. Remember that. So we can now replace the definition of mass, the expression for mass for the tension as given by equation 2 and equation 1. So we connect these two. Tension is equivalent as mass 2 times acceleration is equals to the minus sign, yeah? Mass m1g m1. And this is the equation of motion of the system. The final task remaining here is to solve for the acceleration of the system. And this is just algebra, m2a, this comes across the equal sign and becomes plus m1a, this goes across the equal sign is plus m1g. Factor out A, we get M1, M2 is M1G. We divide both sides by the sum of the masses. These cancel out. And the acceleration of the system is mass 1 divided by the sum of the masses times the acceleration due to gravity. This is the acceleration of the system. Do we have any questions? Oh yeah, thank you. That's clear. You are right. You always have to check for unit consistency. And you see that this is kilogram meter per second square, and this is kilogram. So kilogram cancels kilogram, and we are left with meter per second square. So this is unit consistent. Any other question? Okay, thank you. So there's no other questions. If you have any question that comes to your mind at the end of this class, feel free to send me an email or schedule an office hour with me or come to the regular office hours. Other than that, there will be a homework at the end of the week for you to have opportunity to practice this thing out yourself.